إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونستهديه ونعوذ بالله العظيم من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، إنه من يهده الله فهو المهتد ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. الحمد لله الملك القدوس الظاهر العلي القاهر رب الدهور والأزمنة مقدر الأوقات والأمكنة أبديا لا يحول وملكا لا يزول صاحب العز الشامخ والجلال الباذخ احتجب بالأنوار وتعزز بالاقتدار ذو القوة والجبروت. ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، له الملك وله الحمد يحيي ويميت وهو على كل شيء قدير. ونصلي ونسلم على سيد البشرية جمعاء سيدنا ونبينا وحبيبنا ومصطفانا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، خير من دفنت في القاع أعظمه فطابت من طيبهن القاع والأكم، نفسي تتوق لقبر هو ساكنه فيه العفاف وفيه الطهر والكرم. حبيبي يا رسول الله، الحق أنت وأنت مصباح الهدى ولك الكتاب الخالد الصفحات، من يحيى الحياة بغير هديك يلقها تيها من الأهوال والظلمات. أرسلت داعيا إلى الرحمن ودعوت فاهتدت لك الثقلان، أخرجت قومك من ضلالات الهوى وهديتنا للواحد الديان. صلى عليك الله يا علم الهدى، ما هبت نسائم وما ناحت على أيك حمائم. ثم أما بعد، indeed there is no all praises to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. All praises to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We seek his help, we seek refuge with him, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala almighty, and we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept our good deeds. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept this time in our good deeds inshallah. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to consider this time amongst, you know, the best time of us inshallah, that we will remember at the day of judgment, at the day of judgment, that the time, that this is the time that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepted our repentance in it. My dear brothers and sisters, today inshallah we are going to talk about one of the worships that a lot of Muslims sometimes, you know, forget about it or ignore it. This worship is something that does not need a lot of physical actions. It is worship that we will learn from the ayat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the verses of ayat Allah, of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when we study them today inshallah. And I would like to start with the first ayah that we will learn about this worship, that sometimes we neglect it because of sometimes our ignorance of it, or because that sometimes we are not thinking that this is one of the priorities in our deen. The first ayah that I would start with is the ayah in which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, لَيْسَ عَلَى الضُّعَفَاءِ وَلَا عَلَى الْمَرْضَى وَلَا عَلَى الَّذِينَ لَا يَجِدُونَ مَا يُنْفِقُونَ حَرَجٌ إِذَا نَصَحُوا لِلَّهِ وَرَسُولِهِ وَمَا عَلَى الْمُحْسِنِينَ مِنْ سَبِيلٍ والله غفور رحيم ولا على الذين إذا أتوك لتحملهم قلت لا أجد ما أحملكم عليه تولوا وعينهم تفيض من الدمع حزنا ألا يجدوا ما ينفقون. In this ayah Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, there is no upon the ill or the upon the weak, and there is no upon the ill, and there is no upon those who do not find anything to spend. Means here, spend for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Any guilt, if they are sincere to Allah and to His Messenger. Wallahu ghafurur rahim. Allah is the most merciful, Allah is forgiving. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the second part of the ayah, وَلَا عَلَى الَّذِينَ إِذَا أَتَوْكَ لِتَحْمِلْهُمْ. And nor on those or upon those who came to you asking you to take them along. قلت لا أجد ما أحملكم عليه. You said, I don't have anything to carry you upon. تولوا. Then they went back or turned back. وأعينهم تفيض من الدمع. And their eyes are tearing. They are weeping because you didn't take them along with you. حزنا ألا يجدوا ما ينفقون. Out of grief that they didn't find what they can spend. This ayah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks about certain situation that happened during the time of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. It was the ghazwa the battlefield of Tabuk. And you may know that this Ghazwa was at a time that was very tough time. It was during the summer in Arabia at the time. It was very hot weather. And also, it is the end of the summer, or closer to the end of the summer, and there is no fruits, no crops at that time that they can, you know, they use what they collect, what they harvest at the beginning of the, or at the spring, or at the beginning of the summer, and then they are closer to finish it. They don't have a lot of saved food. And the Prophet ﷺ asked the Sahaba to give sadaqat for preparing the army so they can go into Tabuk, which is far away from Al-Madinah Munawwara, about 600 miles or something like that. It's long distance in the desert. And he asked them, he tried to mobilize the Sahaba to be prepare an army so they can go and confront the Roman army that time, that was in Sham, that was in Syria that time. And it was big, you know, big test for the Sahaba that they were asked to give sadaqat at a time that most of them do not have a lot to give. And it is also tough test that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has put all the Sahaba in it, that Allah wanted them to go to battlefield that is far away in that harsh weather. So a lot of Sahaba, you may know the story that Abu Bakr Siddiq and Uthman ibn Affan, all of them, you know, give sadaqat, but there were groups of the Sahaba or individuals of the Sahaba who were very poor and they didn't have anything to spend. Those that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala described them in this ayah, that they were crying because they didn't have anything to do, to spend for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They didn't have money or wealth or food that they can, or rides that they can give to the Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam so they can contribute in this battlefield. And then when the Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when they went to the Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asking him to take them along, just find a ride for them so they can just, you know, join the battlefield to fight, to be soldiers in the army. But the Prophet ﷺ couldn't do that because the Prophet ﷺ didn't have extra rides for them. So he told them, I don't have nothing, I don't have any ride for you, so Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive you. And they went back while they are very sad till, you know, the moment that they started to cry because of that. One, these Sahaba or these individuals were seven Sahaba. They were known in the seerah as Al-Bakka'un, the weepers. They are known in the seerah like Al-Bakka'un, or as Al-Bakka'un. These Sahaba, one of them named Ulba ibn Zayd, some of the references call him Tha'laba ibn Zayd. Ulba ibn Zayd, this one of the great Sahaba, he was poor. And this Sahabi went back while crying, and then he thought, you know, he couldn't, you know, he felt guilty because how come all the Sahaba are contributing and participating in this battlefield? I cannot do that. So he didn't find anything to do except standing up before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala at night, making tahajjud and praying to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then he started to pray and cry and make whisper to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and telling him, oh Allah, يعني لقد رغبت في الجهاد وحثثتنا عليه. You encouraged the Muslims to go for jihad, and you know that I don't have anything to spend. I don't have a ride, and I don't have money to spend for the sake of you. And he didn't find anything to give for the sake of Allah except what he said next. He said, اللهم إني أتصدق بكل مظلمة لي على مسلم في جسدي أو في عرضي في سبيلك. So he said, oh Allah, I would give sadaqah with any, or with my rights on any Muslim who had, you know, harassed me or bullied me or insulted me. I just gonna forgive him for the sake of you, oh Allah. So he was saying this to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then he spent his night this way until the Fajr time, and then at the Fajr time he came to the masjid of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And then the Rasulullah sallam, after finished the salah, he started to speak to the Sahaba, and he used to do that always. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam stood up and you know, in front of the Sahaba and asked, who was the Sahabi or the person who gave sadaqah last night? Where is the one who gave sadaqah last night? And then Ulba says, as he narrates that, he says, I didn't know that he means me, but he stayed quiet until the Prophet asked the question 3 times. At that moment, he realized that this question or the Prophet ﷺ meant him. And then he stood up and said, oh, Rasulullah, I am that one. He asked him to tell him what happened. And he told him the story that I just mentioned. And then the Prophet ﷺ said, وَالَّذِي نَفْسِ مُحَمَّدٍ بِيَدِهِ لَقَدْ حَسِبَهَا اللَّهُ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى فِي الزَّكَاةُ الْمُتَقَبَّلَةِ وَالَّذِي نَفْسِ مُحَمَّدٍ بِيَدِهِ لَقَدْ كَانَتْ مِنَ الزَّكَاةِ الْمُتَقَبَّلَةِ The Prophet ﷺ swore to him and say, by that one who the soul of Muhammad is in his hands, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala Almighty, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepted it in the zakat. It is acceptable zakat. So imagine that situation, brothers and sisters. Imagine that situation that someone, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told his prophet about his actions, his deed at night, and about something that he didn't give. He didn't give nothing, right? He had nothing to spend except just something which is sincerity that he has in his heart, and he find nothing to give to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala except just forgiving his brothers in Islam. Whoever bullied him, whoever insulted him, he just forgive him for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah accepted that in the zakah. Remember, I told you that the great sahaba and the wealthy sahaba spend a lot in this ghazwa. So Uthman ibn Affan gave a lot. You know, he gave sadaqah or charity for thousands of camels, you know, that can, you know, carry the sahaba for this battlefield. And Allah mentioned only this situation of Ulba ibn Zayd. So let's reflect a little bit on this situation and compare it with others or other group. Here we're talking about the bakka'un, the weepers, the sahaba that they have sincerity in their hearts and they give nothing. And they didn't spend or make this ibadah a lot compared to the other sahaba, but Allah accepted it. Look to the opposite situation. In another situation, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was talking about a group of Muslims that they will come after the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and those are the Khawarij. They were also known as al-Haruriyun. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was telling the sahaba about them. And he said, وَاللَّهِ إِنَّهُ لَيَحْقُرُ أَحَدُكُمْ صَلَاتَهُ إِلَى صَلَاتِهِمْ وَصِيَامَهُ إِلَى صِيَامِهِمْ وَتِلَاوَتَهُ إِلَى تِلَاوَتِهِمْ So the Prophet ﷺ is describing the status of those of this group, which is the Khawarij that came after the Prophet ﷺ. And he tells who? He tells the Sahaba, not normal Muslims like us. He tells the Sahaba, who were the best amongst the Ummah of Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. He tells them that the one of you, when compares his deeds, his good deeds, his prayers, his siyam, his zakat, his recitation of Quran, compared to them, he will belittle them. He will look down to what he's doing compared to what they are doing. Means that they do a lot of worships, right? Means that they do a lot of salah, they recite the Quran a lot, right? They give zakat, they recite the Quran, they do a lot of good things that we when we looked at them, sometimes we look down to ourselves. We think that our good deeds are insignificant compared to their good deeds. And at the end of the hadith, the Rasulullah SAW says, يَخْرُجُ أَوْ يَمْرُقُ أَحَدُهُمْ مِنَ الدِّينِ كَمَا يَمْرُقُ السَّهْمُ مِنَ الرَّمِيَّةِ The one of them exit the deen in a way similar to the arrow when it hits or when it passes through the target. So when there is an arrow and goes through the target and passes through, didn't stop on it, this is the way they exit from the deen. Although their prayers, although their fasting, although their, you know, their zakat and all the good deeds they do that they do. But they exit the deen that fast. And they take nothing from the deen. Here we had two, you know, two situations that are completely, you know, opposite to each other, right? One of them, Sahaba, who didn't give physical things, who didn't do a lot like the other Sahaba, but Allah accepted from them. And another group who do a lot of worships, but at the same time, they exit the deen that fast. What could be the reason of that? When we think about these two situations, we'll definitely learn very important lesson related to the topic that I'm trying to address in this khutbah. This lesson is that sometimes or all the times, a'malul qulub, the deeds of hearts, are most important than, or the, you know, more important than the physical deeds or physical worships that we sometimes pay more attention to. So most of the Muslims are paying attention to the salah, alhamdulillah. We pray. When Ramadan comes, we fast Ramadan. We give the zakah and sadaqat. We give the charity. We make hajj, right? We do all good deeds that people can see and, you know, point to us and say they are good Muslims. But at the same time, we may forget the deeds of heart. The deeds of heart are very important. Because of them, your deeds, your other deeds, your other worships might be acceptable or might be rejected from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Similar to these two situations that I told you about. And that's why when you look at the dua of Ibrahim alayhi salam, the supplication of Ibrahim alayhi wa ala Rasulina sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, as-salatu wa salam. In the Quran, Allah talks about Ibrahim and on his tongue when he was saying this dua. He was saying, قَالَ رَبِّ لَا تُخْزِنِي يَوْمَ يُبْعَثُونَ يَوْمَ لَا يَنْفَعُ مَالٌ وَلَا بَنُونَ إِلَّا مَنْ أَتَى اللَّهَ بِقَلْبٍ سَلِيمٍ. So Ibrahim عليه السلام, خليل الرحمن, the friend of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he used to say this dua. He says, Oh Allah, لَا تُخْزِنِي يَوْمَ يُبْعَثُونَ. Do not disgrace me at the day they are resurrected. He talks about the day of judgment. يَوْمَ لَا يَنْفَعُ مَالٌ وَلَا بَنُونَ. At the day that there is no wealth or no sons or, you know, children benefit anyone except من أتى الله بقلب سليم. إلا من أتى الله بقلب سليم. Except those who come to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with sound heart. So what the sound heart is? So Ibrahim alayhi salam, when he selected certain thing to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with, he selected that part. Okay? He selected to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he chose to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give him sound heart. So he meets Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala at the day of judgment with just sound heart. Not ill heart. Not a heart that has a disease. I'm not talking about, you know, health diseases that we're talking about here. We're talking about the diseases of hearts that are hidden, that no one can see it except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that's why the Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam instructed us in one of the great ahadith when he says in this hadith, Inna fil jasadi la mudgha. In the body of the human, a piece of flesh. Idha saluhat, saluha sa'irul jasad. Wa idha fasadat, fasada sa'irul jasad. If it is sound, if it is reformed, the whole body will be sound. And if it is spoiled, the whole body gonna be spoiled. And he said at the end of the hadith, and this is the heart. This is هذا هو القلب. So القلب or أعمال القلوب here, the deeds of hearts, are very important, as we understand now from the du'a of Ibrahim alayhi salam, from the hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, in this, you know, that it is very important that sometimes we neglect, sometimes we ignore that, you know, the sincerity, you know, of our hearts when we do any worship. And this is very important. So, a'mal al-qulub, the deeds of hearts, brothers and sisters, are very important because it will get you in Jannah, inshallah, the day of judgment, as we saw in this ayat. Not only in Jannah, it will also risk you in the dunya. And makes you from those who are happy in the dunya and happy in the day of judgment, in the hereafter. And as I said, the deeds of heart are important because they're going to rescue from the hellfire also at the day of judgment. And we can understand this from another hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and it's famous hadith that most of us may know this hadith and memorize it. It is the hadith of the sab'a alladhina yuzilluhum Allah fi dhilli yawma la dhilla illa dhillu. It is the hadith of the seven types of people that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will put them under the shade of his throne at the day of judgment, at a day that there is no shade except his throne's shade. The sab'a, hadith of sab'a alladhina yuzilluhum Allah fi dhillihi yawma la dhilla illa dhillu. In that hadith, when you look at the seven types of men that Allah, or people that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will protect them at the day of judgment, you're going to find five or six of them are related to the deeds of hearts. Let's review them together. So at the beginning of the hadith, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, imamun adil, a just ruler. So justice is something physical, right? But also it has hidden part of it, which is the intention of the ruler to establish justice between the people, right? So it's heart's deed, because the ruler has, you know, he can do whatever, especially in the, you know, dictatorships like, you know, we see in some of Muslim countries nowadays. They can do anything and nobody can, nobody holds them accountable of what they are doing, right? They cannot establish adl or justice except if they have the intention and sincerity to establish this adl upon the command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Imamun adl. And the second one, وَشَابٌ نَشَأَ فِي طَاعَةِ اللَّهِ, a young man who grew up in Allah's obedience. Means that he's a young man who grew up from his, you know, young age until he became a man in obedience of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He was doing good. He doesn't do the bad things that usually people at this age might do. These are two things that we can, you know, think about them. And I think the shabun nasha fi ta'atillah is excluded from the topic that we're talking about. Look at the rest of them. The third one, rajulani tahabba fi Allahi ijtama'a alayhi wa tafarraqa alayhi. Two men, they love each other for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They like each other for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ijtama'a alayhi wa tafarraqa alayhi. When they gather for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And when they leave each other for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to do something good. When they gather to study Quran, to talk about hadith, to encourage each other to do something good, to cooperate, you know, to help each other to do something good, right? And when they leave each other for the same reason, for something that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will be pleased with. So, and this is rajulan tahabba. So al-hub, the love here for the sake of Allah is a deed of hearts. It is not something physical that you can catch and measure, right? It is something in the heart. Nobody can see it except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The fourth one, وَرَجُلٌ قَلْبُهُ مُعَلَّقٌ بِالْمَسَاجِدِ. And a man, his heart is attached to masajid. A man, his heart is attached to masajid. Whenever he goes away from the masjid, he likes to go back to do prayer, to make adhkar, to recite Quran, to make, you know, voluntarily prayer, something like that. His heart is attached to the masjid, to serve the masjid, to clean it, to serve the guests of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. رَجُلٌ قَلْبُهُمْ مُعَلَّقٌ بِالْمَسَاجِدِ وَرَجُلٌ دَعَتْهُمْ رَأَى ذَاتِ مَالٍ وَجَمَالٍ فَقَالَ إِنِّي أَخَافُ اللَّهِ. And a man who was seduced by a beautiful and wealthy woman, she called him to do illicit, you know, relation, and then he said, he rejected that, and he get himself away by saying, إِنِّي أَخَافُ اللَّهِ, I fear Allah. So this man didn't do physical worship, right? It is something in his heart, the fear from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's one of the heart's deeds, right? رَجُلٌ دَعَتْهُمْ رَأَةٍ قَالَ إِنِّي أَخَافُ اللَّهِ وَرَجُلٌ تَصَدَّقَ بِصَدَقَةٍ فَأَخْفَاهَا فَلَمْ تَعْلَمْ شِمَالُهُ مَا أَنْفَقَتْ يَمِينَ. And a man who gave a charity and he concealed it at an extent that when his right hand gave the charity, his left hand didn't know it. So this is also something, it's a'mal qulub, it's ikhlas, right? It's sincerity to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. A lot of, you know, donors, when they give the charity, sometimes they think about how they look to the people. When the people will point out to them and say, hey, they are very generous. They are donating to the masajid a lot. They are donating and giving sadaqat. So sometimes here, you know, the nafs might interfere here and take some of this ajr. But this man who gave the sadaqah and concealed it, that there is nobody knows about it, even his left hand. This is just metaphor that the Prophet used here to tell how he was intentionally concealing it. So nobody knows about it. And this is ikhlas, this is sincerity. وَرَجُلٌ ذَكَرَ اللَّهَ خَالِيًا فَفَاضَتْ عَيْنَاهُ. And a man remembered Allah by himself while he's isolated from all mankind, by himself, nobody else with him except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And he remembered Allah, and then فَاضَتْ عَيْنَاهُ, and his eyes teared. He cried from the khawf, from the fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or from the hope in his Jannah. So this is also al-khawf wal-raja. It is one of the heart's worships that sometimes we neglect and do not pay attention to it as much as we pay attention to the physical worships. And this is the lesson of today, inshallah, that we need to pay more attention to our hearts when we do any worship, when we do any good deed. We need to think about our heart, the status of our heart at that time. Sometimes people give less sadaqah, but they become in higher rank at the Jannah. In higher rank. And there is very famous situation with one of the Sahabi that is unknown. His name is unknown in the seerah. He was one of the Sahaba that when he comes to the masjid, or before he enters the masjid, the Prophet ﷺ was telling the Sahaba, the companions, that there is a man of the Jannah, from the Jannah will enter this majlis, this halaq. And then they look, they found that man. He comes and entered the halaq. So it's a glad tiding from who? From the Prophet ﷺ, that this man from the people of Jannah, right? And then next day, or another situation, similar thing happened. The Prophet said, يَدْخُلْ الْآنَ عَلَيْكُمْ رَجُلٌ مِنْ أَهْلِ الْجَنَّةِ. Now there is a man from the Jannah, from the people of Jannah, will enter this halaq. And then the same man entered the halaq, or the masjid of Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. And this is repeated three times. So one of the Sahaba was very curious to know, what does this man do? What kind of worships that, you know, elevated him to that level of iman that makes the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam give him glad tidings with Jannah three times? He didn't say that for other Sahaba in that situation. But this man who is unknown, for is not famous Sahabi. And then one of the Sahaba, you know, tried to know what happened. What does he do? What kind of worships? And then he went to him and, you know, he made a story just to let him host him in his house for a night. He was just curious to stay one night in his house, to be his guest for one night, just to see how he worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, what kind of worships. And then he found him doesn't do a lot of extra worships like he thought, you know. He found him just praying Isha and praying the salawat on time, and then he sleeps early, and then at night he woke up to make, you know, tahajjud, but not for long tahajjud, short tahajjud, and then he slept, and he has normal life, like the Sahaba, like other Sahaba. So he became more, you know, curious to know. And then at the morning, he was frank with him and told him, I made up this story just to stay in your house for one reason. I wanted to know what kind of worships you are doing so I can learn from you, because I hear the Prophet ﷺ says this, this, and that. At that moment, this man was, with happy with what he heard from the Sahaba, and said, wallahi, nothing, except that when I put my head on my pillow, I have nothing bad in my heart towards any Muslim. He cleans his heart from any envy, from any bad things towards any Muslim. So by this only, by this heart deed, he won that rank in Jannah. And this is something that we all have to learn from. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم. And make repentance to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept from all of us. الحمد لله وكفى وصلاة وسلام على عباده الذين اصطفى ولا سيما عبده المصطفى صلى الله عليه وسلم. ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده وأن محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم لا نبي بعده. بلغ رسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح الأمة وكشف الله بالغمة وجاهد في الله حق جهاده حتى أتاه الله اليقين ثم أما بعد. My dear brothers and sisters, our topic today is the importance of the heart's deeds. And we gave examples from the Quran and from the Seerah and from the Hadith that tell us the importance of the deeds of hearts, that sometimes we neglect or ignorant of its importance. And today I just wanted to, you know, shed light on it so we can remember that all the time we do good deeds. We need to look at our hearts first and see the status of the hearts. Are we doing this for the sake of Allah, or we do it for other reasons? Do we seek only the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for what we are doing, or we are seeking also the pleasure of other people? So we can, in this situation, people might have ishraq billah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because they are not doing the good deeds just for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. A'mal al-qulub, the deeds of hearts, are a lot. So I tried to count just or make a list of some of the deeds of hearts that we can think about and, you know, and think of and try to root them in our hearts. For example, al-ikhlas, the sincerity, al-tawakkul, reliance on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. All of these do not need any worship, do not need you to wake up early or to go and make wudu or to spend money or go or walk to a certain place to do something. All of these are just heart's deeds. Sincerity, reliance on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, love for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, patience, repentance, tawbah, fear from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, al-raja, hope in the ajr from in the reward from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Al-tasdiq al-jazim wa adam al-shak means that you believe, your belief is, you know, you stand firm in your belief. You have no doubt in your deen and your belief. This is kind of, you know, of heart's worships. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, إِنَّمَا الْمُؤْمِنِينَ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا بِاللَّهِ وَرَسُولِهِ ثُمَّ لَمْ يَرْتَابُوا. Allah says, ثُمَّ, then they have no doubt in their belief. This is kind of heart's worships. النِّيَّة, so the intention in any worship you do, or in any deed you do.